Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jackie B. I've always wanted to do that, but I never have. So let's act like you guys knew I was gonna do that. Hey guys, my name is Jackie B. Welcome back to my channel. Today is gonna be a get ready with me video. Just me doing my makeup, talking about whatever I want to talk about. I didn't want to do a makeup tutorial. I did want to do a makeup video, but I didn't want to do a makeup tutorial. So let's just get to it. It might be a little long, but this is the look, which, guys, look at it. It's glitter. How can you not like glitter? So if you guys just want to chit-chat girl time, girl boy time, you know, talk to me, listen to, actually not talk to me because it's not live, but you know what I mean, okay? Let's listen to some of my favorite songs. Using Mac Studio Fix Fluid. I swear I started getting pimples and I don't even know why. What is up with that jam? You know what I mean? Now I'm gonna go in with my Pro Longwear Concealer, which is an oldie but a goodie for sure. This one looks first. Yeah, I think it might be a little too late. Dang, what color was that? Is it really this color? Why does MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, the NC25, looks darker than NC30? So I'm gonna mix those two and that's what I'm gonna use. I haven't used this concealer in such a long time, but right now I just don't have like the right shade of concealer, finally admitting that. Like I got the Tarte Shape Tape, but it's definitely a little dark. I got a lot lighter during the winter, so I need to go get, I was going to get a lighter shade, but they didn't have it, so I just haven't gone back. But I really do need to go. I want to go to Ulta. I'm just going to blend that. Okay, I'm also going to go in with Pro LA Girl Pro Concealer in Beautiful Bronze. And I never do this, so I'm going out of like my comfort zone right now. I'm going to contour. With a cream, which I hardly ever do. So let's see how this works. I don't want to do my double chin. Which this actually is drying kind of fast and I'm not digging it, but your girl already put it on her face. See that? So I have no choice. See, I don't have the time for this. I don't know guys, but as I'm getting older, I'm just so sad at how like I don't get ready as much as I used to anymore, and it's really upsetting. But I'm always doing everything. Okay, this nose contour is what's gonna scare me the most. Like, I'm already hating it. So I'm definitely gonna go in here with, like, NARS Creamy Concealer to help a sister out, because this nose concealer or contour is, like, a nose job gone bad. Okay. Snatched. Just kidding. I'm also gonna add a little bit of this NARS concealer because I feel like the other one was a little too light and had no, it was more of a cool tone, and this is a little more warm tone. I think this is ginger. Yes, it's ginger in the NARS concealer, and I just feel like it will just make it all better. I feel like this contour looks way better than this one, But in all honesty, I feel like I'm a little... Oh, shit. Guys, it just squirted out the oil. You know what I should have done? I should have mixed this, and I didn't. But you know what? I'm kind of scared to go in and add more, so I'm just going to fix that with powder. Let's talk about something. What do you guys want to talk about? Well, first of all, let me self-promote myself, because what kind of channel would it be if I didn't self-promote? Follow my vlog channel if you guys haven't already. I do have a vlog channel where I vlog my daily life. Not daily vlogs, but pretty much my day-to-day life when I feel like it. Usually I upload Mondays and Fridays right now. So go check it out. It's I have a family. I have 3 kids and a husband. So go follow my vlog channel if you're interested in my day-to-day life as a stay-at-home mommy. And then follow me obviously on Instagram. Hello, it's 2017. So yeah, and then Snapchat as well. All the links will appear as I'm saying it, or they'll be in the description box. I'm gonna talk about being a teen mom. I became a mother at the age of 18. Yep. Found out I was pregnant at the age of 17. And I'll tell you guys, I guess, how I got pregnant. Not how I got pregnant. How I found out I was pregnant. I was actually working at a hospital at that time. And I was at work. And at that time, I used to work in the kitchen. So I was in the kitchen washing dirty dishes. We had to, like, scrape off the food. And then put them in, like, the machines to wash. It was like a line. People doing this, right? So, as we're scraping off, and that day I think I was a scraper. And I think, I'm pretty sure that's what it was even called. A scraper. And as a scraper, you have to scrape off the food. Off these plates. Or any remaining garbage and stuff. You throw it in the garbage. And, you know, you have a bunch of smells and textures and stuff, and then there's like hot water running in this little sink, and then you kind of just scrape off anything that you need to throw in there. Oh, dirty mirror, sorry. In there. So with all that like steam, the hot water, the hotness in that room, it was just really nasty smells. So I just started feeling really nauseous and sick. And I thought it was, like, the food and, like, the job that I was doing. I was like, oh, my God, like, I'm going to throw up. And sure enough, I did start throwing up in the garbage can. So I'm like, okay, that's odd. And I think I was a little late with my monthly visitor. But I didn't really think nothing of it until I started getting nauseous and throwing up. I was like, that's a little odd. So during my break at this job, I decided to go get a pregnancy test. Because obviously I wasn't going to take a pregnancy test at home because my parents, right? And you guys, I don't know if you guys know, but Hispanic parents are pretty strict. They don't really talk to you about the birds and the bees. It's more like they expect you to just know that you're not supposed to do it till marriage. You know, I knew that was like the rule, but they never really would talk to me about how to protect myself or anything. It was more like, you can't do that, you shouldn't be doing that, and that's it. Like, nothing else. Like, never really had conversations about it. It was just pretty much like they assumed that I wouldn't go there because I wasn't supposed to, and that was it. There was never a, hey, you know, well, if that was to happen, make sure to use protection. Not that your parents want you to have sex, obviously. I get it. But, you know, I don't know. I just feel like maybe if they would have been a little more open, my parents, and, like, talked to me about it, maybe I would have been more cautious. I obviously was scared that they would find out, so never did I ever, like, I mean, we use protection sometimes, but I just, like, now I realize, like, my friends that we talk, and we're like, well, you know, I actually went and got protection from the doctor for birth control, but I never used my insurance. Like, I paid out of pocket, and I'm like, well, that was genius. Why didn't I think of that? You know, because I wasn't gonna ask my dad for my insurance card, like, for him to find out or anything, obviously. So, anyways, back to my story. I talk too much and I get sidetracked. But we went, so I went, because I was working, to get a pregnancy test from the pharmacy, drugstore, and yeah, I come back, go in the bathroom because I could not even wait any longer to see if I was pregnant or not. Took the test and positive it comes out. Honestly, I was in shock. Like, I could not believe it. Like, seriously, unbelievable. And I called Juan. I called Juan, my boyfriend. And I tell him, I'm like, yo, like, I think I said, guess what, or something. Yeah, I did, now that I remember. And he guessed it. He's like, you're pregnant. And I was like, how did you know? And then he said that he did it purposely. That's what he said, but honestly, I don't think he did. I know, I mean, I think I know him, right? At the time. I think that he got really nervous and he kind of like, that was, he's very type of person where he's very like, oh, like if something surprises him, but he doesn't let that be known. Like, he has everything under control. You know what I mean? Like, he knows everything kind of deal. He knows how to fix everything. And I think that, honestly, I think that was his reaction. Like, oh, yeah, I know. And I'm like, no, how did you know? So at first, I was kind of pissed. I was like, you really did that on purpose? Like, at first, you know? But then he's like, no, that's not what I meant. And, yeah, so we were just like, what are we gonna do? I was just sick to my stomach. Sick to my stomach. You know, I was really tired. I didn't want to talk to my parents. As much as I was doing something that I knew I shouldn't have been doing, I hated lying to my parents. I felt so bad. If you know me, people know I tend to be honest, Holly. I don't like lying. So I avoided my parents as much as I could because I knew that the less time I was around them, the less nervous I was going to be, the less anxious, the less horrible like person feeling I was going to have, you know what I mean? So I just tried to avoid them. And then fast forward, I want to say a few days or weeks, I don't even remember because I have Alzheimer's already. Kind of. I remember like me and my boyfriend would talk about like how are we gonna tell my parents. I really didn't even know the plan. I didn't know how long to wait. The only thing I did know is that I went to like a Planned Parenthood kind of place or something for young, like you can go in there and they'll like double check with like a urine test to see if you're pregnant just to make sure. And sure enough, they confirmed it. So anyways, fast forward to when I tell my parents, obviously, well, first of all, that night was very unplanned, completely. Did not even tell my boyfriend I was gonna tell my parents. Did not even tell them. Oh my God. Can you guys? Oh my goodness. Do you guys see this? Holy bejeebies. I never even use this salt. I hope I'm using it right. Honestly, guys, I used to be like the biggest makeup junkie. Well, not the biggest because there's people out there that take this to another level, but such a big makeup junkie. And with the kids now, it's like so hard. Like, my priorities just changed. You know what I mean? Guys, I am so impressed right now. Okay, I think I was saying that the day that I told my parents was very unplanned. I just couldn't take it anymore. I could not take my conscience anymore. And I spilled the beans. I was home. My boyfriend was not there. He did not know I was gonna tell them. I was in the laundry room with my dad, and I just said, I have to tell you something. And I started sobbing, like, completely. And then he, like, knew. He knew I was pregnant. But he's like, I know what you're going to tell me. He's like, but I want you to say it. And it took me a few minutes, I'm not going to lie. And finally I said it, and he just hugged me. I honestly thought he was going to, like, beat me up. I was, like, expecting a few slaps here and there, you know what I mean? But no, he hugged me. He hugged me. Now, my mom, on the other hand, that was a different story. She wanted to beat me up. But that didn't happen. But she was really upset. It took her forever. It was like somebody died in the house, pretty much. Which I don't blame her, you know. As a Hispanic, Latina, Mexican girl, woman, your hopes are that your kids will walk out of the house wearing a white dress as virgins, you know? So I completely understand why she was upset. But she did say some really hurtful things that now I still to this day think of what she said to me. And just can't believe that she went there, because now I see how much she loves Danny, which is, he's 10 now. And just can't believe how awful, like, what things she said, you know? So, yeah, she was very upset. And then after that, it was just planning what was going to happen. Was I going to move out? Was they, of course, as a normal Mexican family or a very traditional family, they expected my boyfriend and his parents to come over and have a talk with them and talk about the situation and meet each other. They had never met before, so that was really awkward, super awkward. But they did. His parents were pretty upset as well. We were very nervous. Oh, rewind a little bit. So when I did tell my parents that night, so my boyfriend was calling the house just like a normal day to talk to me, and I wasn't answering my cell phone. And then how he found out that I ended up telling him was that he finally called. He knew something was wrong, he said. He's like, I knew something was wrong. So he called a house phone, because back then there was house phones. And my mom answered and, like, cursed him out and hung up on him. And then he said that he kept trying to call, even if, that, like, she did that. And she just kept hanging up on him. So then he said I think he told his cousin to come with him. And because he didn't have a car, I don't remember. But to come to my house. And he said he was driving around or parked around there for hours. He was just so nervous too. And I didn't have him come in that day. I was just like, no, you know, like, I don't even know if I talked to him that day, to be honest. But yeah. So yeah, then we decided to move in together, and that was pretty much it. Moved out like a month or two later, and we just tried to make it work, you know? So I put on my liner and my lashes. I think I effed up my liner a little bit, but I didn't want to take it off. And that's where I'm going to end that story, because I remembered that I wanted to talk about something else. But before we get on with another topic and let these dry, let's listen to another one of my favorite songs, and I'm going to play that right now. Love this song. To the next topic, I'm also applying, I'll say it since I'm doing it, it's this MAC Melba Matte Powder Blush. Really cute color. Somebody requested me doing a video about how to make money and manage to be like a stay-at-home mom or make money on the side and do that, you know what I mean? Because I know sometimes some families, they can't depend on just the husband, boyfriend, whatever, one income. So, because let's get real, life is expensive too. that's what I'm gonna talk about. For the longest time, I wasn't a stay-at-home mom. I am right now, but I still occasionally work here and there. How can you make money? It depends on what you want to do. If you have a passion, if you have something that you enjoy doing and you can make it a job, do it. Because honestly, when you're happy and doing and working, doing what you love and getting paid for it, that's just like a plus. So if you have something like that, go ahead and do it. For me, for a long time, it was doing makeup. I'm also a makeup artist. So that was my way of making extra money. I did work at a hospital in a call center for a short time, and that was nice because it was very flexible hours, part-time, and I was able to make some money then. What else? I would say if you're into photography, do it. If you're a good like seller, I'm not, but like if you can sell Herbalife and all like stuff like that and you're good at it, do it. If you have people that if you're a person like I can't sell shit, okay? Like I'm not a salesperson. I'll tell you what I like, but I'm not into like selling stuff. But like yeah, if you're creative, like for all like start your own business, go on Etsy. Like there's so many opportunities now to start your own business, like Instagram and like promote yourself. That's free, you know. So like if you have something that you can do yourself and like sell, like do it. You know, that's really the only tips I can give you guys. I'm gonna try to talk and do this at the same time, but I know I'm like gonna get sidetracked. But as I apply my highlighter. Those are pretty much like the only things I could tell you guys. Just find something that you enjoy doing. That's like the best advice I think I can give you guys. Because for me, for the longest time, it was applying makeup or doing makeup. Like I was obsessed with that for the longest time. Right now, I can honestly say that I don't know if that's what I want to keep doing, and I'm okay with that. I'm just more focused right now on my kids and other things, like, just other things that I have going on. So I don't know if that's what I want to do, but you know what? It's great money. So if you're into makeup and you think that you would be a good makeup artist, give it a try, because you can make some money doing that, for sure. But then again, like I'm glad I had the help. I had my family to help me babysit my kids. But that was the way that I helped bring income. But for the longest time, at the beginning of the relationship, which goes hand in hand with what I just told you guys about being a teen mom, I was the only one that worked. Juan did not have a job, like an official job. He was a musician, but that wasn't cutting it because I wasn't like happy about him going out on the weekends at night, and plus being pregnant, like being home alone. So I was the one, working. But then years down the road, I was able to stop working because we were struggling with babysitting, and I would just make money on the weekends and stuff like that. Ooh, look at this highlight. It's pretty. So if you can make your own little business and be happy while you're doing it. Maybe like a workout coach, like a Beachbody coach or something, if you're into fitness, just anything, you know? Like, just do it. Just do it. Because let me tell you, when I was, after I had my son, the age of 18, I was just working. And my parents, like, again, I'm Mexicana, Latina. They weren't gonna force me to go to college, and if I was to go to college, I had to pay for it myself. Even if I wouldn't have got pregnant, like that was gonna be the case. So after I had my son, I wanted to go to beauty school, and they didn't think it was the best idea. They just thought that I should get a 7-to-3 job or an 8-to-4 or 9-to-5 job. And settle with that. But I wasn't gonna settle. I wanted to do something that was gonna make me happy, and I did. And you know what? Honestly, like I work doing jobs that I completely loved, and I'm so happy that I went with my instinct and followed my dreams, and I did it. But now I'm like over it, and I'm kind of disappointed that I'm a little bit over it, but I don't know. Does anybody else feel that way? Do you guys get me? Like, is this an age thing or what? Because I never thought that I would get over like makeup, and I just did. Like, as a career, do I really want that anymore? I don't know, and I feel a little lost, but I don't know. I don't know. Is this normal, guys? Talk to me. All right, I just gotta fix my lash a little bit, but I think everything's coming together pretty nicely. Do you guys like it? I'm like mucosa because I'm like sick. So sorry. That's also why I was like, man, Jackie, it's not a good idea to do a get ready with me because you're gonna blow your nose and everything's gonna go down the drain. But I really been wanting to put like a makeup video out there. But there's like so many like makeup gurus right now that I was like, I don't really want to do a tutorial. So I was thought that this maybe was a little more interesting, like getting ready with me while we're chatting, you know, have a little conversation going or something. Maybe teach you guys a little bit of what, I mean, not teach you, but you know, just share my life with you a little bit more. What do you guys think? Do you guys like the video so far? Stop right now and comment below. Pause this video. Is this fun or not? I'm gonna go ahead and create a lipstick color for myself using the Anastasia lip palette. So I mixed 1, 4, and 11, and I got this color here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and apply it. I was talking about the makeup thing, makeup artist. And say you're not really that great at makeup and you want to do it, doesn't mean that you can't. Let me tell you something. Like anything else in life, the only way to improve in something is by practicing. If you don't do it, then you're not gonna see change, you're not gonna see improvement. And that as well with makeup. Some girls are like, it's because I don't know how to do my makeup. It's because I don't know how. Well, you know what? If you constantly don't try to do it and learn, then it's never gonna change. You're never gonna know how. You know? I don't know how to blend eyeshadow. Well, I didn't either. I taught myself. So, like, you know, just by consistency, practicing, just like anything else, even like with losing weight, like everything's consistency, you know? Do it on yourself. Practice on yourself. And then, you know, hopefully you'll see improvement. If you can't, practice on other people. But completely different doing makeup on yourself than doing that on somebody else. But at least you're practicing, you know, the technique and you get an idea. Okay, I'm not the best at lining my lips, but then again, that's because I don't do my makeup hardly ever anymore. So, okay. I'm definitely. Oh! Pretend that never happened. Tips on that. Ooh, this little brush from what is this? Real Techniques is super good to clean your lip area, your lipstick accent brush. All right, so I went to get my gloss. Put some of this on because I want to be like Kris Jenner. Do you guys know like Kris Jenner always has some gloss on, and it's like fabulous. This is the Coco, the Kylie Cosmetics Coco Collection Damn Gina. I'm going to just finish off the eyeshadow by putting on a little bit of something under the brow. I'm not gonna highlight. I thought about highlighting like the inner corners of my eyes, but I'm not because I feel like the glitter is already enough. Like, I don't need to be too extra. Can you guys guess where I'm going today with this makeup? I mean, I'm thinking about taking it off, but you know what? I already did it, so I don't think I will. I'm going to the library. So this is a little extra for the library, but you know what? If you're not extra, then you're boring. So I guess I'll be extra today. That felt good after all this powder on my face. All right, what was I gonna say? Woo! My eyeliner is a little messed up, but I'm just gonna let the lashes block it, and that's it. But I am completely obsessed with the Stila Diamond Dust. You guys, this is the shit's nits. This is in the shade Diamond Dust, so super pretty. So that's all for this get ready with me video, and I hope you guys like this kind of video where I kind of get ready and share a little bit of my life with you guys. If you guys have any topics, if you guys like this kind of video and have any topics you guys want me to talk about, let me know and I can do that. Don't forget to click like and subscribe and leave me a nice little comment. Okay. Go check out my vlog channel. Follow me on all my social media, which will be listed in the description box. And I will see you guys next time. Bye. Please go subscribe to this channel because I just said so and it would make me feel better. Let me go get my J-Lo on.